grinding hard on the job. Can't take that from us. Are you ready? Hey. Is you ready?
Ready.
You say you ready.
Oh.
Whole squad ready.
Ready.
Is you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Ready.
Is you ready?
Well, with the roof shut, the conditions will be comfortable here at Miller Park in Milwaukee. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Chicago Cubs and the Milwaukee Brewers. It's baseball on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. Zach Davies, a Washington-born right-hander, gets the starting assignment. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, thanks, Matt. Zach Davies coming on to pitch. Not a big, strong guy, but he's a control guy that pumps the strike zone full of strikes. 89 to 92 miles an hour with sink. Has a curveball, has the slider, and also the straight changeup. He needs all four of his pitches, not overpowering. You'll know if he's on early, he'll be throwing a lot of ground balls.
And this is taken out there by Braun for the first out. With that, a look at the Cubbies' starting lineup. Danny, who stands out to you?
Well, of course, you have to like what Anthony Rizzo brings to this offense. He's an imposing figure with a bat in his hands, always seems to turn in a good at-bat, and he could do a lot of damage when he barrels up the ball.
First pitch fastball in on the fists for ball one.
Well, I think that's a great spot for that pitch, in on the hands. It wasn't a strike, but if he can command the movement in there, he's going to be very effective in this one.
1-1 the count. The 1-1 is in there for the second strike.
Two strikes.
Hits this one hard the other way, and that gets through for a one-out base hit.
Adapt and persevere. That's what I always said on the offensive side. Down in the count right there. Batter hits a ground ball the other way. He's able to fight off a tough count and get himself a base hit.
Anthony Rizzo is at the plate as he takes a cold strike one. 1-1 the count to the Cubs first baseman. Head-to-head numbers against Zach Davies. He's got 8 hits in 25 tries. Now a swing and he gets him to pop it up. But this will land untouched. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. To second for one. Return throw is in time. How about that? They do turn two, and it gets him out of the inning. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Kyle Hendricks, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, Kyle Hendricks is not one of these overpowering guys. He's a little bit, he reminds me of Greg Maddux. He's 88 to 91 with really good sink, great straight changeup, and has the slurve. Not a true curveball, not a true slider. The key to Kyle Hendricks, inducing early contact. The more pitches that hitters see, the better chance they have to hit on him. If Kyle Hendricks is on, you'll know early he'll be getting a lot of quick outs.
Lorenzo Cain is in to start things out as he swings and misses at that one at strike one. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Curveball got him swinging for the first out. Time now for a look at the hometown Brewers starting lineup. Mark, what do you have on this group in front of the home crowd tonight?
Yeah, you take a look at this lineup they're running out today. And they got their work cut out for them with the sinker baller on the mound on the opposition side. They're going to have to see the ball up. They're going to have to work the home plate umpire. Can't be given 4 to 6 inches off the inside half, or he's going to have a field day pounding that sinker in there. Should be interesting to see right out of the chute if he's got the good one or not.
On to first, and a good stretch over there is going to get him by a step for the second out. Here's Brian Braun now. His matchup numbers with Hendricks. He's got 8 hits in 31 tries. He's also been a strikeout victim 6 times. Now a swing, and this ball is crushed straight away center field. And it's gone! Solo home run. As the Brewers get on the board first, it's 1-0.
always talk about how important it is to spot your starter or run it to early in the game, and he does just that, blasting a no-doubt bomb that serves notice. They're going to be swinging with the wood here. No better way to get the home crowd into it right out of the gates.
Batting fourth.
And that brings up the left-handed hitting Travis Shaw. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Here's the 0-1. Hit softly down the line at first. But that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Looked like a breaking ball that time, but it never came back down. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And the throw to first ends the inning. Now the Cubs' four-hole hitter, Javier Baez, last year's recipient of the Silver Slugger Award for NL second baseman. One ball, no strikes, the count. In there, and it's even at one. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez. The 2-1. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. The 2-2. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Popped him up. Arcia moving to his left. One away.
All right, guys, here's a defensive alignment for the Milwaukee Brewers. And let's take a look at one of the most dynamic infielders in our sport, and that's Orlando Arcia. Playing up the middle, shortstop, premium position, cannon arm, highlight reel plays, the ability to make the routine one as well. The bat will continue to get better.
Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field.
He's lucky it's only a single back up the middle and not a double in the gap or a home run. Pitches like that in a show get absolutely hammered.
Into the box, Kyle Schwarber. No balls and a strike to count. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Yelich is under it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. So in now for Chicago, David Bote. He'll get to take his first cuts here. 0-1 the count. Contreras leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And here's one that misses to the Chicago second baseman. It's a ball and a strike. Hit down the third baseline. A bouncer up the middle. And that is through into center field, a base hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Fastball hit on the ground is short. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Into the box now, Mike Moustakas. He'll start things out against Kyle Hendricks as we get the inning underway. No contact on the sinker there, and he's behind 0-1.
Hey, boys, you talk about getting your A swing off. That's what it looks like right there. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
So here's how the Chicago Cubs are positioned defensively.
Batting fifth.
And guys, the thing I want you to take a look at today is in today's game, the new age, everyone wants to move around. This manager does not like to shift a lot. Maybe a step to your right or left, but there's a lot of trust that the pitchers are going to execute. So let's see how it works out for them in this one.
Big swing by Grandal and a ball carrying well to right. And it's gone as they add still another. shot here to straightaway right field. And the Brewers move out in front now 2-0. Just an absolutely amazing home run there. Certainly worthy of the show track treatment. And as you can see, 114 miles an hour off the bat, and that should give you a pretty good indication as to how well he connected on that swing.
That is seven. The first baseman.
Standing in now, Jesus Aguilar. Yes, he'll pick on the first pitch and line one back up the middle, and that's a base hit.
Loud noises right here, fellas. Hey, he's going to have to mix it up a little bit more because they are on his stuff.
Orlando Arcia.
Next to bat, Orlando Arcia, as he's well in front of the curveball and comes up empty there for strike one. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two. Digging in now for the Brewers, Zach Davies. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss on the sinker, 0-1.
I think he just subscribed to the swing hard in case you hit it philosophy of hitting. As a pitcher, why not? Better than standing up there like you.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. But the Brewers get a run, and it comes here on the long ball. We play two. It's 2-0 Milwaukee. Cubs pitcher Kyle Hendricks. He'll step in to lead it off in the top of the third. Swing and a miss, but he's right on here. One strike. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. And not much of an effort there as he'll look at strike three called, and on three pitches, he's your first out of the inning.
He's looked great on the bump the first few innings of this game, and I think his ability to change speeds effectively has been a big reason why. That was a good change of speed for the strikeout there, and I've seen a lot of hitters look pretty off with their timing so far.
Under it is Yelich, and there are two away now. So two are gone now in the Cubs' half of the third, and into bat next, former National League MVP Chris Bryant. In there for strike one, 0-1.
Here's a perfect situation. Two outs, bases empty, power hitter at the plate. He ain't looking for a...
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Next for Milwaukee, Lorenzo Cain. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
And it's safe to say he doesn't look all that comfortable up there. 0-2 now.
Wow, not sure what that was, but talking about having your mind made up you're going to swing before the pitcher even throws a pitch, I don't know how you swing at that pitch.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Now batting, right fielder.
In is Christian Yelich.
Yelich.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. First pitch swinging as this one's hit on the ground to second. On to first, and very quickly, two are gone here in the home third.
The left fielder.
So two away in the Brewers' half of the third. And that'll bring in the left fielder, Ryan Braun.
The last at bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Boy, he comes back with a beautiful pitch there, and he's dominating this at bat. It's 0-2 now.
Real nice curveball there. Had a lot of late break, and he waved right through that one.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Change up, and he ain't buying it. 1-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a miss got him reaching. Contreras finds it. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Nothing across here this half. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
The first baseman, Anthony.
There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Lays off a fastball that doesn't miss by much, and it's 2-0.
Talk about certain guys in the lineup that you want to be really careful with. This guy right here is one of those, and you can tell he's pitching awfully cautiously.
Swing and a miss, strike two. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. He's at the knees and called strike three.
Now batting, shortstop.
So one away here in the Chicago fourth. And into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. Grounded slowly to the left side. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
Now back.
There's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. One for one after a single this first time up. Strike one to start the at-bat. This is hit out to right. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Seven in a row he's set down now as the side is retired. Striding forward now, the Brewers cleanup hitter, Travis Shaw. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. And he waves at a curveball there. No balls and a strike.
You might see a change of game plan right here from the pitcher and catcher. They have to find a way to get these guys off that early count meter. Look for a little bit of change of pace.
And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now that is.
Digging in now, Mike Moustakas, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Hit hard on the ground towards second, and that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Two-seam fastball, sinker. He stayed inside it. Didn't have the action the pitcher would have liked.
Yeah, that's a sinker right there, Mark. It's intended to be down in the zone. This kind of pitcher better get the ball down because he can't live up in the strike zone.
And that's cut on and missed, 0-1. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Moustakas, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And up next will be the power-hitting first baseman, Big Jesus Aguilar. Who started him with the change, and it's nothing in one. One pitch, and he can't make contact on the bender, 0-2.
Well, we know what this guy's approach is. He's looking to go absolutely deep right here. I don't see him getting anything over the heart of the plate.
And he'll go the short way to retire the shot. Milwaukee leaves one. They're up 2-0. Back here in Milwaukee at Miller Park as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. Between innings, I was able to discuss the current state of the Cubs lineup with manager Joe Maddon. And flat out, he told me they just need to put better swings on the ball right now. He said they're searching for ways to drive the ball with some authority because it's just not happening for them today. They haven't gotten an extra base hit yet, so it's been a real struggle getting guys into scoring position. But the key, he said, is not to panic. Sometimes you just have to fight through the downturns and keep your focus and energy high.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out.
Now back. second baseman.
First delivery to him on the way. Fastball that gets the inside corner, strike one.
His pitch count is in a really good place at this point of the game. He's pounding the zone and getting first pitch outs just like he did on the last guy. We might see him work deep into this game if he keeps this up.
The right fielder, number two.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Carlos Gonzalez. Right side and right into the shift. Moustakas has it. Throw over to Aguilar at first. He'll take care of him to end the inning. Stepping into the box, Orlando Arcia. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Not shortstop.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Arcia.
What a pitch to start the at-bat there. It's nothing and one.
Step out of the box and wash that one off because that was an ugly swing.
And a good pitch there as this ball swung on and popped straight up the chute right around home plate. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
Now batting.
So now the Brewers pitcher, Zach Davies. Here's the first pitch to him. First pitch is a sinker, too low, 1-0. A pretty healthy hack that time. It's 1-1. Two runs, four hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
That's been a great pitch for him all night. Able to push and pull the throttle a little bit, throwing a good fastball located and mixing in that nasty changeup with good arm action.
Got him.
And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
The center fielder.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring up the center fielder, Lorenzo Cain. Curveball taken outside to begin the at bat. Ball one.
Kind of surprised not to see a fastball on the first pitch there. The guy's probably taking at least one pitch to give his pitcher a chance to sit down after he already made the second out.
A 1-1 count to the Brewers leadoff man. The 1-1. Is swung on and missed for strike number two.
I love the fact that this batter continues to be aggressive, but after striking out twice already, maybe he's got to take a step back, see the ball a little bit deeper, and be willing to work deep into the count.
And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a The next Cub up, Kyle Hendricks. He's set to lead us off in the sixth inning. Hot shot on the ground is short. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Here's Jason Hayward now. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Here's a called strike about thigh high, nothing and one.
We're moving along in this one, heading into the middle innings. This guy continuing to pitch well, and one of the reasons why, first pitch strike ratio over 70% up to this point in this game.
Here's Chris Bryant now. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
This guy has been unbelievable. There were billboards outside Wrigley while he was still in AAA. And what does he do when he shows up? Rookie of the year, MVP. I mean, get in line.
Two out, nobody on. Sliced hard on the ground and a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. He'll get it into second. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance, right?
And the shortstop is under it to make the play, retiring the side. So striding in, Christian Yelich. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Schwarber moves over. One down. Ryan Braun will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. Go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on. Good off-speed pitch had him out in front for strike one. And a big swing there by Braun, but he comes up empty. No balls and two strikes. Trying to send him packing for the second time. A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two. Digging in, Travis Shaw. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. No contact on the sinker there, and he's behind 0-1. Hits are now even at four apiece. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ball. Here's Javier Baez. And guys, seventh inning already. Hey, I'm not complaining, but this one's been flying by.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you get when both starting pitchers have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
Yeah, and it's resulted in a game that could really go either way in these late innings. Now a swing, and he popped him up, straight up, as this is right around home plate. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. So stepping in, Kyle Schwarber. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. Swing and a miss, 0-1.
We're moving along late into this one, and it's no surprise this guy continues to pitch well. Over 80% of his first pitches have been for strikes. And when you're doing that, you really put the hitters on the defensive.
Nope, tried to get him out front, but it's a ball 1-2.
Well, that's a smart miss there. Sometimes guys will chase it down there, especially when they're in protect mode on an 0-2 count.
That one misses, and I think a ballpark full of umpires disagrees. It's 2-2. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. Throw over to Aguilar at first to take care of him to end the inning. Nothing across here this half of the inning. Seventh inning stretch time upcoming here in Wisconsin. It's the Brewers 2 and the Cubs nothing. At the plate, Mike Moustakas. He singled his last time up.
The second baseman.
Open stance by Moustakas, and now the pitch. Swing and a miss at a first pitch changeup, nothing in one. Even 1-1 count to Moustakas. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
Well, when you're behind in a count like this pitcher is, it's a good time to work in something off speed if you're confident in it. Most hitters are looking for fastball.
3-1 to him now. And he takes a cold strike at the knees, and that'll run things full. He's just rolling right now, and even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame. Yasmani Grandal will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning. He flashes you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. That's popped up. But this will land untouched. Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now. Two runs, four hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Hit hard on the ground to second. Moody from the outfield grass. And that's the second out. Striding into the box, Jesus Aguilar. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. First pitch of the at-bat. A shot to first base and caught there to end the inning. So So coming to the plate, David Bodie, a hit in two tries so far. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Cubs have someone working in their bullpen now as a right-hander's begun to get loose. Popped him up. Shaw is there. One out. So one gone here in the Chicago eighth, and standing in the right fielder Carlos Gonzalez, and that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-for-3 game so far.
What a nice piece of hitting right there. Didn't try and do too much. Stayed on the attack. Kept his hands inside the ball and took what the pitcher gave him.
Albert Almora.
And this is popped foul, but perhaps playable behind first. But this will land untouched. Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. Gonzalez leads off first with one away. Now a hard liner. Takes this the other way to right. But this will hang just long enough for him to run it down in shallow right for the second out.
Up next for the Cubs.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. One ball, one strike, the count.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. He cannot be late right there.
And the third baseman is there to make the catch, and the inning is over. Brad Brock is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Now to the plate, Orlando Arcia. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Got him reaching a bit too far after that one. It's strike one. And he misses with it, 1-1. It looks like the Cubs will get a left-hander up and working out of the bullpen. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Here's the 2-1 home. There's a breaking ball, but it's laid off and doesn't find the zone.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt him over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Zach Davies. He's been great on the mound, so we'll see if he can do something with the bat here as well. He's earned a chance to take this at bat.
Yeah, Matt, when a guy's throwing the ball as well as he has, it kind of forces the manager's hand to stay with him. He's been exciting to watch.
And he's into second safely with a stolen base.
You don't see that very often against this guy. This guy has one of the best arms in the game, but still a successful steal at second base.
Here it comes, 1-0. Well, should be 2-0, but he goes way out of the zone to go after that one, and it's even 1-1. So 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
It's funny. That pitch, I can picture being in the box. That pitch looks so good to hit, and why does no one ever get to it? A good executed high fastball usually blows 9 out of 10 guys away.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out. The runner at second, one away, and that'll bring up the center fielder, Lorenzo Cain. Here comes the first pitch. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. On the move is Hayward. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and hit for third. And he'll make it up to third on the fly ball as he's in there now with two away.
The batter, the right fielder.
Now with the play, Christian Yelich. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Now here's the signal from the dugout, so he'll take first here on the intentional walk, and that makes runners at the corners with two away.
Well, they felt it was better to take the bat out of the hands of a guy like that. He's just too dangerous, and they decided they'll take their chances with the next guy in the lineup.
Into the box, Ryan Braun, and they're runners at the corners now. From Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch.
Zero.
And that swung on and missed for strike one.
Boy, the Brewers haven't done much up to this point. They need to get something going, and they need to get it going right now.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch. He's running. Fouled away. From the belt, the pitch. He'll try it again from first. Fouled off. He'll try it one more time for second. Pitch outside. The throw. Not in time as he steals second.
This catcher has an elite arm. But when you get that great of a jump at first base, it makes it a lot easier to steal second.
The set and the 1-2. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His trying to pick things up where we left off. Chris Bryant and his guys need him to get things started here in the top half of the ninth. In there, a base hit.
And that's just another base hit in a long line of many. Seems like he's been pitching from the stretch the entire game, but somehow he's still got a shutout going. We'll see how long he can make this last.
Pulled toward right center field. Yelich is under it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Digging in, Javier Baez, 0 for 3 to this point.
Yeah, not his game so far. He's such a good hitter. We all kind of expect him to pick up 2 or 3 hits most of the time. That's not really how baseball works, though.
Behind 0-2 now. The 0-2 home. Now, look out as he's got to hit the deck here. It's ball one.
You know, he's one of their guys they rely
on. Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. Meanwhile here, this is going to be trouble out there in left center as it ought to be good for extra bases. And they're on the board as now it's a 2-1 ball game.
He was on cruise control the entire game, but he gets brought back to reality here. An RBI double gets them on the board. And now that they've broken the dam, we'll see if they can generate some more runs going forward.
Josh Hader answers the call from dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one. He's set and the pitch. Fastball in there for a call strike.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher to get ahead right there. You know you got a star hitter at the plate. He's not afraid to go to two strikes or go deep in the count. That's what you have to do. You have to put him at a disadvantage with the count.
King will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two. Stepping into the box, Kyle Schwarber. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Throw to first is in time. They got him, and the ball game is over.
Well, as a former pitcher, you know I love these low-scoring games as opposed to those slugfests. This was like a throwback game when home runs weren't so common and pitching was really dominant. No complaints here.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Brewers jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Zach Davies gets the W on the mound. Kyle Hendricks racked up 12 strikeouts but still ends up taking the loss. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB Network. Good night, everybody.
The line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Brewers, 2 runs on 4 hits. No errors. They left 4 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 37 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely. This is what you need. This is that tongue in cheek.
me street, but the numbers speak like, come on, come on. It's going down, I'm about to free fall. I hold it down like a packet on a seesaw. I do it bigger than bigger, I do it big, y'all.